when the word research comes up, to the greater population, we see people in white lab coats holding up beakers and looking at solutions, and that's what they see as the background of research. You must always be in a laboratory. But that's not actually the case.
So when I first started doing research, I kind of had the stereotypical view of a bunch of people in lab coats, you know, mixing things together and beakers.
You think it's all like beakers and that. You don't really get an idea of what social science research looks like.
Our students are doing research in every discipline across campus, and every one of those pieces of research look different.
It was just amazing to have individuals from philosophy, from communication studies, the discipline that I was preparing to enter into, and then from economics and from history, and Dr. Claire Sanders and other individuals who had such an impact on my undergraduate experience in the classroom, had an even greater impact on the way that I performed that research, thought about research, and was able to actually put together a final project that I'm really proud of.
All of us do who work with students and research is to get students to understand more clearly what research is. I really am the guide on the side, and it's fascinating to watch the process.
The real gift of an honors college to these students is that we can provide the resources the students need and the opportunities they need to be the best they can be. So one thing they need is guidance. They need our fabulous advisors here who really know how to take them step by step from their freshman year to their senior year.
It's like a parent-child relationship where I'm, as a mentor, I'm trying to show the way to the student that I think as a mentor is the best way to grow. This kind of relationship is very deep and personal, and it's something that I think most research advisors experience.
For me, I've known my research advisor since I was 10. So you start to sort of develop this personal connection with that person, and I think that's really special.
When I go out into the community and talk to families and students about research, I always ask them how many people have done research before, and very few hands go up. And then I say, how many of you ever had an idea about something and then you went to see if you could do it? And the hands slowly go up like this. Well, you just did research. You had an original question and you went to original materials to try to figure out an answer. That's research.